club.
Okay, we're up here in Knockeven and we're here with my father and Jim and Catherine, and we're here at a lime kiln that was built by my father and his father, James Fitzgerald, back in about 1952, that'd be right?
Yes, that's right.
Okay, and when you tell us then, Dad, who was involved in that?
Well, me and my father, and I was attending him to build it with stone, because he was a stone mason.
And where did you get the stone from?
Local stone, it's all local stone here from Knockeven.
And how long did it take you to build it, roughly?
About 2 days, yeah.
Okay.
We built it in 2 days, yeah.
And who was, were you attending him?
I was attending him, yes.
Okay.
It was built twice, of course, it was only stone upon stone. There was no cement in between, because otherwise with the heat, the cement would crack and there'd be no addition.
Okay.
So we built stone upon stone there, you know. And it's just, you start off with in the bottom, about 18 inches in diameter. And you get it, it gets bigger then as you go up, and you eventually it's about 6 foot in diameter at the top, or 7 foot in diameter. And it's sloped for the thing to drop down into. And the idea was to produce lime, for that's what was used in for painting houses and whitewashing houses and walls and everything. It was also used as fertilizer. And when we light a fire, eventually we got it up and running. We got stone from Ballyhaline brought over here, limestone. We had to have limestone to burn it, because the stone here wasn't suitable. So we had to have limestone to burn it. And so what we do then, we start a fire in the bottom with sticks and turf. And we put about 12 or 14 inches of turf and sticks in. Then we put 12 inches of limestone on top of that, then turf again on top, and limestone every other time until you get to the top. And then you light it from the bottom and it starts to burn. So you have to stay with it then for about 48 hours because it kept dropping down as it was burning, and you keep topping it up. So we have to stay up day and night.
So would you literally stay up here physically?
No, we go back and have a cup of tea and that, you know, but okay. We'd be able to time it, the time to come back and to need a top up.
Okay. So yeah. Can you show me where the lime used to come out then? When
there was a hole right down at the bottom here, about 18 inches square. And you take the lime out from there with a shovel and fill it in, and you sell it by the bucket, 1 6 pence per bucket. And people would be queuing up to buy it to do the outside of their houses. And everything was done by lime then. There was no paint, there was nothing.
Was there many of these around the area?
Only another one that I knew of in Luke, belongs to Father Fatty. There was one outside his house, but I've never seen it used. But this was used on a regular basis when we got it up and running.
And what time of the year would you be making the lime then?
The springtime, April and early May. That's when the people would be whitewashing the houses and the walls all around, and sheds and everything. Everything would be whitewashed.
And what sort of stone is this now? It's not limestone, is it?
No, this is all green stone here in the quarry right on the side here. My father, because I was standing on the top handing down the stone to him to build it, and I dropped the stone and hit him in the head. But lucky enough, he ducked and he got a bit of an injury, but we just carried on anyway.
Okay.
The job had to be completed and finished, which it was.
Right.
You know, because there was money involved in it. Even 46 pence a month was a lot of money then.
Yeah.
You know.
And whose idea was it to build a kiln?
My father always wanted to do that, yeah. But he never got round. He was involved in the stone business and the quarries all his life. But eventually, in about 1952 or 53, he took on and we built this.
I see.
And we've got it into production. And to see it today, today is 2019, a bit of damage on the top of it, with the stone upset and that. So lovely and smooth and nice all around the top. We will use it.
Do you think whoever owns the land today realise what this is?
No, a fellow by the name of Paddy Gayer, the builder, he owns the land now at the moment, but I'd say he wouldn't even know what this meant.
Okay.
Yeah.
There might be no harm to mention it to him sometime, so that's never touched.
I will mention it to him, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But he probably have seen the building here, but it means nothing to him.
Yes.
And the young crowd, it means nothing to him, you know. But it means a lot to me now, and I didn't know if it was demolished or not. But it's not just demolished, it's still there, just a bit rough around the top and overgrown with ferns and briars and all that carry on, you know. And it needs a bit of a trim, and I might come back sometime myself and Catherine and trim all the rock, because there's an electric fence there at the moment and we can't get too close to it.
Yeah.
You know, but Catherine is a great workman, she does.